Hello dear students, welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, and what is the name of our lesson? That is reproduction in animals. But today during this biology session, I am not going to teach you anything. Rather, I am going to tell you one story, the story of one sheep which name was what? Dolly. That is what? The story of Dolly the clone. Okay, so what is meant by Dolly, how it get produced, what is the cloning process, all these things we are going to see deeply in this session. So the Dolly was a sheep which was born with the help of one process, and the name of that process, that is what? Cloning. Okay, so what is meant by the cloning? Let's see the definition of the cloning. Cloning is the production of an exact copy of cell, any other living part, or a complete organism. Okay, so cloning is a one type of the process in that the production of an exact copy of the cell, any other living part, or a complete organism takes place. Okay, so with the help of this cloning process, there was a production of one sheep, and her name was what? Dolly. So how it get exactly produced? Cloning was the first successfully performed by an Ian Wilmot and his colleagues at the Roslin Institute in Edinburgh, Scotland. So he cloned a sheep. Okay, so with the help of this cloning process, they cloned one sheep and they named that sheep as a Dolly. So this Dolly was born on 5th July 19. This is the story of the Dolly, how it was born. But now, how exactly this cloning is happened? So how exactly this cloning process is takes place? Let's see. So during the cloning of the Dolly, what happened exactly during the process of this cloning of Dolly? The two sheeps are there. So there were the two sheeps were present. The first sheep was Finn Dorset sheep. And the next one, or the sheep number two, is what? Scottish Black Face Ewe. Okay, so like the two sheeps were there. From the first sheep, that is from what? Finn Dorset sheep. From this Finn Dorset sheep, the cell was collected from the mammary gland. Okay, from the mammary gland, the mammary cell is collected. But from this cell, the nucleus was removed, okay, or the nucleus is separated from the cell. Okay, so what we have done up till now, what we have discussed, there were the two sheeps. First sheep's what? Were Finn Dorset sheep. The second sheep was what? Scottish Blackface Ewe. From the first sheep, that we can say that what? Finn Dorset sheep, the mammary cell was collected from mammary gland. But from this cell, the nucleus was separated, or we can say that one nucleus was removed from the cell. Simultaneously, the eggs was collected from the Scottish Blackface Ewe. Okay, and from this egg, the nucleus was removed, or this cell becomes empty by removing the nucleus from that. And now, what is the next process? Then, in this empty cell, the nucleus of the Finn Dorset sheep is get implanted, okay, or get inserted into this empty cell. But this empty cell is we have obtained from who? Scottish Blackface Ewe. Okay, so the empty cell of the Scottish Blackface Ewe, in that cell, the nucleus of the Finn Dorset sheep is get inserted. Now this cell is remain as it is for the further development, for the further dividation. So this cell started to get rapidly divides and started to form the number of cell and get converted into an embryo. And then that embryo is get inserted into the Scottish Blackface Ewe. And that embryo started to get developed into the Scottish Blackface Ewe shape. And after the certain period of the time, this Scottish Blackface Ewe sheep give the birth to the sheep which name was what? Dolly. Or this Scottish Blackface Ewe gives the birth to the Dolly. Dolly was given the birth by the Scottish Blackface Ewe. Though the Dolly was given the birth by the Scottish Blackface Ewe, but the Dolly was totally identical to the Finn Dorset sheep. Okay, the fine dorset sheep. Why is it so? Because as we know, the characters are passing through the parents. Okay, and where are the chromosomes are present? So where are the genes are present? Inside the nucleus. But in this cloning process, what we have done? We have taken the egg from the Scottish black-faced ewe, but we have taken the nucleus from the fine dorset sheep. And that is the reason the Dolly is identical to the fine dorset sheep, because whatever the chromosomes or whatever the genes are passing from the parents to the offsprings, which are present in the nucleus only, and in the cell, the nucleus was present of the fine dorset sheep. That is the reason the Dolly was totally identical to the fine dorset sheep, not like a Scottish black-faced ewe. Still, she has given the birth to the Dolly. Dolly was the fine, healthy clone of the fine dorset sheep. So that Dolly has also given the several offspring. Dolly also produced the several offspring of her own through the normal sexual reproduction. And unfortunately, the Dolly died on the 14th February 2003 due to the certain lung diseases. Several attempts have been made for the production of the clone animals or cloned mammals. However, many die before the birth or many die after the birth. So these clone animals found that they are mainly born with the certain abnormalities. Okay, so this is the story of the Dolly, that is the clone. Okay, and what is mean by the cloning? The mixing of the cell or the nucleus, or we can say that the cloning is the production of an exact copy of a cell, any other living part, or a complete organism. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have finished this lesson here. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video. For today, thank you.